Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for that wonderful welcome. It makes me very happy to be back at the Palladium again. I was here about 2 years ago, and I loved it. And if anything, this engagement is proving to be even more exciting, thanks to all of you. So I'd like very much to get started now with a little musical salute to one of my favorite American composers. I hope you share my enthusiasm for the music of George Gershwin. I hear little whispers about my jacket. I'm glad you noticed it. Now, how about a little popular song? I have one that I'm sure you've heard many, many times. It was perhaps one of the most popular songs in the whole world. But just in case you may not have heard it for some time, I'd like to refresh your memory and do a little bit of Mack the Knife. Song, I really do. It has such a wonderful melody. It's the kind of melody I think would have intrigued some of the great composers of the past. And to give you an idea, here is the beautiful blue Mack the Knife waltz by Johann Strauss. Sometimes I wish that there had been a song like this around when I was a kid studying the piano. I liked to practice, all right, but when it came to composers like Mozart and some of the other old boys, I mean, it sounded like exercises to me, and it would have been so much more interesting if I could have sneaked in a little Mack the Knife here and there. I said before, this song being so popular in all parts of the world, I'm sure that by now, down in South America, they must be playing it as a rumba. And last of all, I thought it's only fair to all the kids who made this song so popular to do it in the style of music that they seem to dig the most. Now let's say we try a samba. You all know how the samba goes, like this. Well, that's the way it used to go, but we all got together and thought it might be more exciting to do this same samba in double time, like this. Certainly looking forward to doing a lot more for you, and I will. Thank you very much. I'll tell you, first of all, I hope you folks will excuse me for a few minutes because I would like to slip out and get into something more spectacular. Oh, you ain't seen nothing yet. And besides, the fellow who made this jacket said I shouldn't stay in the spotlight too long in it because it tarnishes the material. Well, what do you think? I don't think it's too much, do you? Well, I'll tell you one thing, ladies and gentlemen. I've always been the first one to admit that I wear flashy clothes on the stage. I wear them on purpose, too, because I'll tell you why. You see, in America, I found out a few years ago that when my clothes got flashy like this, they were considered costumes, and that's good that they're considered costumes, because in America, then they're deductible for my income tax. Oh, you get the message. Wonderful. Great. Of course, there's a slight catch to it. I can only wear them on the stage. I never wear them on the street like some people think. Oh, no, I'd be picked up for sure. Oh, boy. But really, I must tell you this also. I'm not the first one to wear these kind of crazy clothes on the stage because they really date back to another era in entertainment that I remember very well because I made my professional entrance into show business during those days, and that was during the time of vaudeville. That's when my dad used to play the French horn in the pit orchestra, and he used to sneak me in the front row so I could watch all the artists on the stage and get ideas, and I did. And I thought as long as I was dressed for the part, why don't we go back to those good old days of vaudeville? Fun. Oh, I do it all over again, but I'm out of breath. I really shouldn't be out of breath. No kidding. No kidding. I don't drink or smoke. No. That's 2 out of 3. That's pretty good. Oh, you're slow, but you're worth waiting for. Thank you very, very much. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we are in Paris. I'll always remember my first visit there. It was also my first trip to Europe, and that was back in 1955. And I guess like most Americans in Paris, I did what all tourists do. I took in the sights, went to a few art galleries, and then I thoroughly enjoyed the nightlife. It was wonderful. In fact, I'd like to set it all to music and give you my impression of that first time I saw Paris. very, very much. Thank you very much. Well, well, thank you very much. I'm glad you like that. I love playing that music because it always brings back some very happy memories of that visit to Paris and Europe for the first time. I must tell you, it was really exciting. Everybody was real nice to me, too. Even the press. Yeah. Well, there was one guy, now that I think of it. Yeah, there was one. They got one over there, too. Yeah, that's... Oh, this guy was too much. I mean, really. No, I'll prove it to you. You know something? This guy was even mad at me because I have a mother. And I found out why later. He wasn't as lucky. Oh, well. But I was nice to him. Oh, I was very friendly. I could see he wasn't a Liberace fan or anything like that. But I smiled at him real nice, tried to be friendly. You know, I figured he might become a convert, you know. Oh, I work on him, boy, I do. But this guy, nothing, really. There I'm smiling, trying to be nice. You know what he said to me? What are you smiling about? I told him, I said, I always smile because I'm very happy. And he said, nobody can be that happy all the time. And I asked him why not, which was sort of a mistake because he told me too. He said, if you could hear some of the stories going around about you, you wouldn't smile so much. So you know what I told him? I heard him. Oh, yes. And that ain't all. I started him. Oh, listen, I'm not kidding you, folks. I've heard stories about myself that gave me ideas I never even had before. Oh, but that's show business for you. But don't get me wrong, I love it. I wouldn't trade it for anything in the whole world. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I thought perhaps from this point on we might reminisce a little bit and play a little music that I recall being favorite numbers of yours in some of my previous visits to London. I hope you still enjoy them. Well, we'll just see what happens, okay? Oh, I thought of one. I would like to dedicate to a certain London critic who is away at the moment. I don't want to mention his name and make him famous. But somehow this number reminds me of him. Thank you. part of the boogie-woogie always seems to bring out something out of certain people. Would you like me to play it again so you can all shout, hey? All right. Live dangerously. Do it again, don't you? I got an idea. Let's hear the ladies do it all by themselves, all right? Now it's your turn. And I told those newspaper people there were men in my audience, too. There you go. Oh, thank you. You know, I couldn't help but notice what good voices you all have. Even shouting, hey, it sounds wonderful. I bet you could sing a great song. Listen, I'll tell you what. Try this one for size here, okay? You really do. No kidding. I wish I could afford to take you with me wherever I go. You're ready, aren't you, honey? But I want you to know that if you feel in your hearts you would like to maybe do me a little favor, just tell all your friends and your relatives that you liked the show if you did, okay? And if there's anybody here who maybe didn't like the show, you can do me a favor too. Keep your mouth shut, huh? But all kidding aside, really, if I can find folks like you to entertain, not only during my stay in England, But for the rest of my life, I'll just go on being the happiest guy in show business, and God bless you all for making me feel that. I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces. All day through, they tried to change the name of my theme song in London last year to I'll Be Suing You. In that small cafe, Hyde Park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well. I'll be seeing you in every lovely summer's day, in everything that's warm and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll see you in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon. But I'll be seeing you. Yeah. Thank you very, very much, everyone. You're very generous. Thank you.